In this video, we're going to look at the Pythagorean theorem and how it applies to two special right triangles. The Pythagorean theorem talks about a right triangle. That means a triangle that has a 90-degree angle in it. A right triangle means a 90-degree angle. The two sides that make up the right angle are called the legs of a right triangle, and the other side, the one opposite the right angle, is called the hypotenuse. The Pythagorean theorem states that the sum of the squares of the legs is equal to the square of the hypotenuse, a remarkable and important theorem to know. So we're going to start with that theorem and look at these two very special right triangles. In the case that we've got a right triangle, an angle of 90 degrees, and one of the other angles is 45, the sum of the angles has to be 180, so this angle up here is also 45 degrees. That means that this is an isosceles triangle. That means that A and B are equal to each other. So I'm just going to say that A is equal to B, and we'll use that value B in our calculations. Now suppose that we knew the hypotenuse was X. Then by the Pythagorean theorem, we know that A squared, but A is the same as B, so B squared plus B squared is going to be equal to X squared. So if we knew what X was, we'll be able to find out what B would have to be, because this equation tells us that 2B squared is equal to x squared, and therefore b squared is equal to x squared divided by 2, and we could just find the square root of both sides to know what b is. B is going to be equal to the square root of this is x divided by the square root of 2. Okay, so if we knew what the hypotenuse was, then each of the other sides would be whatever the length of the hypotenuse is divided by the square root of 2. If you like to rationalize denominators, we could have called that a square root of 2 times x over 2. So in the case that the hypotenuse is 1, for example, then each of the other sides would have to be the square root of 2 over 2. All right. Now let's look at this other special triangle. In this case, we've got a right triangle again, so one of the angles is 90 degrees. And if one of the other angles is 60, then this angle up here, this one right here, has got to be 30 degrees. Okay, let's look at some facts from geometry then. Let's make another copy of this triangle right over here. Okay, so a mirror copy of that first triangle. Sorry, I made this a little bit too long here. This should have been a little bit. Okay. let's not try and do too many correcting here. Just kind of use your imagination and say that this blue one is a mirror image of that other one. Then what that's going to mean is that this angle right here is also 30 degrees. And so this whole angle here is 60 degrees. So if this is 60 and this is 60, then in this bigger triangle, this one would also be 60. And so the point is, we now have an equilateral triangle. That means each of the sides of this triangle are the same amount. So if this side here is x, then this whole side here is x. This much right here is x. And so therefore b is going to be equal to half of x, x divided by 2. Okay, so we've found what this shorter side in a 30, 60, 90 right triangle is going to be? It's going to be half the length of the hypotenuse. So now we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find this a value in our original triangle, because we know that a squared plus b squared, and now b is x divided by 2, we saw that from geometry facts, is equal to x squared. So we're going to be able to solve that equation for a to find out how a is related to the length of the hypotenuse. So let's expand this a little bit. We'll walk through the steps. A squared plus x squared divided by 4 is equal to x squared. All right, now what I'm going to want to do then is subtract x squared divided by 4 from both sides and then take the square root of that result. So when I subtract x squared divided by 4 from both sides, I'll have an a squared on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, let's do a little of the work as we go along here. X squared is really 4x squared divided by 4. I need to have a common denominator. I'm looking ahead here. And then I was going to subtract that x squared divided by 4. So if you can follow the steps that we're doing there, we're thinking of subtracting this x squared divided by 4 from both sides. But on the right-hand side, we've already got x squared, and that's the same as an x squared, a 4x squared divided by 4. So now we've got a common denominator, and we can find that. So x a squared is going to be equal to 3x squared divided by 4. Okay, so we'll be able to find a by just finding the square root of both sides. So a is going to be the square root of 3, kind of check out your understanding of square root stuff there, times x all divided by 2. Okay, so if we know what the hypotenuse is, then this shorter side is going to be half the hypotenuse, and this side is going to be the square root of 3 times the length of the hypotenuse divided by 2. Okay, some special triangles. We need to know those two special triangles very, very well.